In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Very pleased to be here today, of course, on this sunny day, where we can rejoice in the mercy of God as he gives us yet another priest for the Diocese of Nottingham. It's an occasion which we celebrate with our friends, and it's very much a family occasion too. So particularly like to welcome Neil's parents, Kitty and Paul and Sister Sharon, and who I know, but there is a brother I've never met called Paul. I'd like to welcome him too. I presume he's here, I don't know. But anyway, it'd be great. Oh, he's over there. There we are. No. I should have. Yeah, sure. You look the same. No. Well, I would also like to welcome Father David Oakley from Oscott, from Mary's College Oscott, which is the seminary that Neil went to and has been there for 6 years. We sent off a rather nice, slim young man, and we got our money. He's twice the size he used to be. The song. And it's a great joy to have you with us today, Father David, and also members of the seminary staff. Also many other friends that Neil has made during his progress towards priesthood. Now priests from many other dioceses, and also those who are presently at the seminary in Birmingham. So I'd just like to reiterate my welcome to you all, and just to say how pleased we are that you have come to join us today in this wonderful celebration. And my brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to
my God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord our God, who in governing your people make use of the ministry of priests, grant a persevering obedience to your will to this deacon of your church, whom you graciously choose today for the office of the priesthood, so that by his ministry and life he may gain glory for you in Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading is a reading from the prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord was addressed to me, saying, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you came to birth, I consecrated you. I have appointed you as prophet to the nations." I said, "Our Lord, look, I do not know how to speak. I am a child." But the Lord replied, "Do not say, 'I am a child.' Go now to those to whom I send you, and say whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to protect you. It is the Lord who speaks." Then the Lord put out his hand and touched my mouth and said to me, "There, I am putting my words into your mouth." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response and psalm is, "Go into the world, alleluia. Make disciples of all the nations, alleluia."
Go into the world, alleluia. Make disciples of all the nations, alleluia.
O sing a new song to the Lord. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. O sing to the Lord, bless his name.
Go into the world, alleluia. Make disciples of all the nations, alleluia.
Proclaim his help day by day, tell among the nations his glory, and his wonder among all the people.
Go into the world, alleluia, make disciples of all the nations, alleluia.
Proclaim to the nations, God is King, the world he made firm in its place, he will judge the peoples in fairness.
Go into the world, alleluia, make disciples of all the nations.
Reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. The love of Christ overwhelms us when we reflect that if one man has died for all, then all men should be dead. And the reason he died for all was that living men should live no longer for themselves, but for him who died and was raised to life for them. From now onwards, therefore, we do not judge anyone by the standards of the flesh. Even if we did once know Christ in the flesh, that is not how we now know him. And for anyone who is in Christ, there is a new creation. The old creation has gone, and now the new one is here. It is all God's work. It was God who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the work of handing on this reconciliation. In other words, God in Christ was reconciling the world to himself, not holding man's faults against them. And he has entrusted to us the news that they are reconciled. So we are ambassadors for Christ. It is as though God were appealing through us, and the appeal that we make in Christ's name is, "Be reconciled to God." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus called his disciples to him and said, "You know that among the pagans, the rulers lord it over them, and their great men make their authority felt. This is not to happen among you. No, anyone who wants to be great among you must be your servant, and anyone who wants to be first among you must be their slave, just as the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
To be ordained priest, please come forward.
Present.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain this man, our brother, for service as a priest.
Do you judge him to be worthy?
After inquiry among the people of Christ, and upon recommendation of those concerned with his training, I testify that he has been found worthy.
We rely on the help of the Lord God and our Saviour Jesus Christ. We choose this man, Neil, our brother, for priesthood in the Presbyteral Order.
Thanks be to God.
My dear Neil, the rite of ordination as a priest of Jesus Christ is one of the most awesome rituals in the Church. I use that word awesome advisedly. It was the word that Cardinal Hume used when he ordained me in 1982. Awesome. It fills us with awe. The rite itself is filled with awe because it reaches beyond the boundaries of our understanding. It reaches into the mystery of God and indeed the mystery of the Eucharist. For you, this is a most important moment on your journey through life as you respond in your particular way to the call to holiness which God our Father has planted in your heart. In responding to this call, you now find yourself at this daunting juncture, and you may now feel the weight of the Church on your shoulders. Perhaps you are feeling whether you are worthy to live up to the expectations of your family and friends, the seminary professors, and of the people and priests of this parish, St. Peter, and of the Diocese of Nottingham. They have all placed their hope in you. But the Lord will support you as a priest. After all, you are his priest, and this Church is his Church. So you have no need to worry. There's much joy to be discovered in your priestly life as you learn to serve God as a priest. the Spirit that we will pray for specially to be bestowed on you today is the Spirit of holiness, the Spirit of sanctification, which enables you to be sanctified and through you for the Spirit to sanctify and make holy others. As a deacon, you received the Spirit of ministry, of service. As a bishop, I received at my ordination a governing spirit. But this Spirit, this same Spirit, is the one who gives us the power to carry out our ministries, but not as burdens to weigh us down, but as a joy, because our spirit is very much the spirit of joy, and it's a joy that brings us closer to the Lord and his people. And holiness, of course, means joy. There's no such thing as an unhappy saint. I first got to know you here in Lourdes, working as a volunteer for the Handicapped Children's Trust. Much of what that went on during those weeks is best left unsaid, I think. But there I noticed in you the old truth that helping others is, you know, better than being helped yourself. Something deeply satisfying in reaching out to others to help them put their socks on in the morning, to help the old chaplain drink his pint, to reach out to those who find life difficult. And through the care which you showed those people, you and all of that wonderful community that was founded for that week discovered Christ. There's so much pleasure and happiness to be discovered in this human and Christian activity of creating a special communion in which we find Christ. It can become addictive. Our Lady of Lourdes has a very special way of calling us together so that we can find her son in the sick, in the handicapped, and in each other. As a priest seeing Jesus in the most difficult places and at the most trying times, you will have a gift which you can offer to help those you serve find deep meaning in their lives. But sharing in this joy as a priest is not as straightforward as it may seem at first. One thing that those who study theology agree upon when asked, what is a priest, is that a priest is the one who offers sacrifice. That's not surprising, even for Catholics. After all, the Epistle to the Hebrews explicitly defines the priesthood by means of the sacrificial function. It is Christ who, both as priest and victim, enters through his death into the glory of his Father, thus making the Father accessible to all his people. Divisions are reconciled, barriers are torn down, and through Christ we are reconciled to the Father. That is the one and the same sacrifice which you will celebrate as a priest as you stand at the altar every day of your priestly life. But if, as we believe, where you stand, at the same place stands Christ, then you are not only sharing in his priesthood as priest, but like Christ, you share in his priesthood as victim. Isaac carried the wood, the priestly function, to make the fire on which it was intended that he should die, the shadowing Christ who carried the cross on which he was sacrificed, so too you will carry the means of your sanctification. So too you will share in the victimhood of Christ. As you offer your life as a priest, the celibacy, the service of God's people, the simplicity of your manner of living, your prayer, you will consecrate yourself, drawing ever closer to Christ. Saint Augustine links priesthood to sacrifice. Because there is a sacrifice, there is a priesthood, he says. And if there is no sacrifice, there is no priesthood. In the Summa, my brother, St. Thomas Aquinas, declares that the chief office of the priesthood is to offer sacrifice. In his lectures on the Epistle to the Hebrews, he declares even more emphatically that Jesus, priest, because he offered himself to God the Father. From today, you will share in the quality, or should I say character, which makes it possible to present oneself before God in order to secure his favor and so to establish communion with him by means of sacrifice pleasing to him. You do this not only for yourself, but for God's people. And to establish this communion means to reconcile sinners. And this implies that the sins are either covered up or atoned for. It's then that the sacrifice of atonement. It is then the sacrifice of atonement that determines the function of the priest. It may come as a relief to you, because there are so many expectations placed on the priest today. You really do have to be all things to all people. But if you cannot sing, cannot run a youth group, play football, pack the church with people hanging on your every word, don't worry, because you might be able to learn these things as time passes. I recommend calling bingo, because then you'll be able to many parish priests. But of course, the reason you're here today is none of these, but it is to be ordained to offer sacrifice. Let me put it another way. The priest as priest is a minister of the Eucharist. Because the Eucharist is the sacrament that sums up all the mysteries of the faith, celebrating Holy Mass is the principal action of the minister of Christ's priesthood. It is the act that defines what the priest is. In your hands, the many grains that make one bread become the body of Christ to be broken and shared amongst his people. The consequence becomes imperative that having been fed with the divine food, we go out and share the unblessed bread with those who hunger. As we share the cup, it becomes a spiritual necessity for us to quench the thirst of those who yearn for truth and justice. Your actions as a priest, at the altar, compel us all to engage with the world around us. So you should not stay in your church just celebrating the sacraments for such as care to attend, as Rudyard Kipling puts it in a wonderful poem. As a minister of Christ, you are ministering to the Word made flesh, a Word that needs announcing more than ever before in these troubled times, a Word that brings truth and healing. So you have to be out there with the sheep, as Pope Francis puts it, getting the smell of the sheep. That's where what you are doing at the altar gets fleshed out. It's your service of others, in your service of others, that you have to shed so many of the things that matter to the world at large. Pride, honor, and riches. You have to embrace poverty, insults, and humility. So that your self-sacrifice, those by your self-sacrifice, those who are lost, they feel the warmth of Christ's love, and through him be reconciled to the Father. The priesthood of Christ, the two functions of being the victim, being the one who offers the sacrifice, are inextricably linked. But being the victim in this sense brings life and opens up the dreamed of future, eternal life. You will bring hope to those who are downhearted. You will go out to the lost and bring them home. You will give meaning to the lives of those who have no purpose. You will call the people of God into being, and you will give them increase. Today is the feast of Saint Maria Goretti, Virgin and Martyr. So may Saint Maria Goretti, whose feast we celebrate today, take special care of you, Neil, the Church's newest priest. She understood what sacrifice meant, and was prepared to be a victim rather than give in to evil. So may the joy of priesthood remain with you throughout your life as you offer all that you are to become to Christ. So my son, before you proceed to the order of the presbyterate, declare before the people your intention to undertake this priestly office. Are you resolved, with the help of the Holy Spirit, to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyteral order, as a conscientious fellow worker with the bishops in caring for the Lord's flock?
I am.
Are you resolved to celebrate the mysteries of Christ faithfully and religiously, as the Church has handed them down to us for the glory of God and the sanctification of Christ's people?
I am.
Are you resolved to exercise the ministry of the Word worthily and wisely, preaching the Gospel and explaining the Catholic faith?
I am.
Are you resolved to consecrate your life to God for the salvation of his people, and to unite yourself more closely every day to Christ the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a perfect sacrifice?
I am, with the help of God.
Neil, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. My dear people, let us pray that the all-powerful Father may pour out the gifts of heaven on this servant of his, whom he has chosen to be a priest.
Let us kneel.
Pray for us.
once more.
Pray for us.
Saint John Fisher.
Pray for us.
All you holy martyrs of England and Wales.
Pray for us.
All you holy martyrs.
Pray for us.
Saint Gregory.
Pray for us.
Saint Augustine.
Pray for us.
Saint Thomas Aquinas.
Pray for us.
Saint Nicholas.
Pray for us.
Saint Teresa of Avila.
Pray for us.
Saint John of the Cross.
Pray for us.
Saint Charles Borromeo.
Pray for us.
Saint Teresa of Lisieux.
Pray for us.
Saint Pius the Tenth.
Pray for us.
All you holy bishops and confessors.
Pray for us.
All you holy doctors of the Church.
Pray for us.
Saint John.
Pray for us.
Saint Patrick.
Pray for us.
Saint Hugh of Lincoln.
Pray for us.
Saint Bernard.
Pray for us.
Saint Cuthbert.
Pray for us.
Saint Benedict.
Pray for us.
Saint Francis and Saint Dominic.
Pray for us.
Saint Philip Neri.
Pray for us.
Saint John Mary Vianney.
Pray for us.
Saint Pio of Petrachina.
Pray for us.
All you holy priests and Levites.
Pray for us.
All you holy monks and hermits.
Pray for us.
Saint Anne.
Pray for us.
Saint Mary Magdalene.
Pray for us.
Saint Catherine of Siena.
Pray for us.
Saint Bernadette.
Pray for us.
Saint Maria Goretti.
Pray for us.
All you holy virgins and widows.
Pray for us.
Blessed John Henry Newman.
Pray for us.
Blessed Cyprian Tansy.
Pray for us.
Blessed Justin of the Holy Trinity.
Pray for us.
Saint Blessed John Paul II.
Pray for us.
Blessed Teresa of Calcutta.
Pray for us.
All you holy men and women.
Pray for us.
Lord, be merciful.
Lord, say your evil.
From all evil.
Lord, say your evil.
From every sin.
Lord, say your evil.
From everlasting death.
Lord, say your evil.
By your coming as man.
Lord, say your evil.
By your death and rising to new life.
Lord, say your evil.
By your gift of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, say your evil.
Be merciful to our sinner.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Guide and protect your holy child.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pope and all the clergy in faithful service to your Church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Watch over Malcolm, our Bishop.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Increase our patience to the priesthood and to the religious life.
Lord,
together in trust and peace.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Strengthen us in your service.
Come to our help, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. You are the source of every honour and dignity, of all progress and stability. You watch over the growing family of man by your gift of wisdom and your pattern of order. When you had appointed high priests to rule your people, you chose other men next to them in rank and dignity, to be with them and to help them in their task, and so they grew up the ranks of priests and the offices of Levites established by sacred rites. In the desert, you extended the spirit of Moses to 70 wise men who helped him to rule the great company of his people. You shared among the sons of Aaron the fullness of their father's power to provide worthy priests in sufficient number for the increasing rites of sacrifice and worship. With the same loving care, you gave companions to your sons' apostles to help in teaching the faith. They preached the gospel to the whole world. Lord, grant also to us such fellow workers, for we are weak and our need is greater. Almighty Father, grant to this servant of yours the dignity of the priesthood. Renew within him the spirit of holiness. As a co-worker with the Order of Bishops, may he be faithful to the ministry that he receives from you, Lord God, and be to others a model of right conduct. May he be faithful in working with the Order of Bishops, so that the words of the Gospel may reach the ends of the earth, and the family of nations made one in Christ may become God's one holy people. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
Father anointed, our Lord Jesus Christ, through the power of the Holy Spirit, may Jesus preserve you to sanctify the Christian people and to offer sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
sisters and brothers, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O God, who have willed that your priests should minister at the holy altar and serve your people, grant by the power of this sacrifice, we pray, that the labours of your servants may constantly please you, and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son, High Priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by the wondrous design were pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with the royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry. Through the laying on of hands, they are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word, and strengthen them with his sacrament. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself, and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Offerings these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly to your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all those who are holding to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Misogynus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting power.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family which we make to you, also for this servant whom you have been pleased to raise to the order of priesthood. In your mercy, keep safe your gifts in him, so that what he has received by divine commission, he may fulfill by divine assistance. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. be pleased to look upon his offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as ones you are pleased to accept the gift of your Son, Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of our high priest, Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angels to your altar in heaven, and then by your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants, who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant then, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Through him and with him, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. To him and with him and in him,
O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
Saviour's commandment taught by the divine teaching, Lord, we pray from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Thank you. Let us pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to your priests and to all your servants, that, united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Always the great and significant occasion for the diocese for having ordination of a priest, a momentous and a historic occasion for a parish to have an ordination. So many thanks to everybody who's come this morning to take part in this truly great occasion. Many thanks to all of the people over years, as well as not the recent months and days, for all the tremendous effort that was put into bringing about this wonderful celebration today. Father Neil will be available after this Mass to offer his first blessing to those who won't be here over the weekend. He'll be available again after his first Mass tomorrow, which takes place at 11:15. So please, for the sake of not exhausting him, if you're here tomorrow, give his first blessing tomorrow. Family has provided catering for 250 people. Well, that's how many we can squeeze into the place. And I think we'll squeeze you all in, so please everybody come. Well, when you turn back onto the road, the Hinkley Road, turn right and go up to the traffic lights. You'll see on your left at the traffic lights the Ukrainian church. If you then go around the corner, there's a car park a bit further to the right. The reception is in the Ukrainian church hall. So please everybody do come up and celebrate with us this afternoon. Hope. That's everything. Thank you.
Something to lean on. I just want to just thank everyone again, especially Father John, not just for his being parish priest here, but also for the work he does as Assistant Vocations Director, along with Father Matthew, who is also here somewhere. And there he is, give a wave. All you young men, that's the man you see. And I didn't bully Neil into this, you know. I just invited him to become a priest. And he responded to the call. So we're very pleased in this diocese that several young men have responded this year. We have three going off to seminary, major seminary, and we have two who are going away for a year's discernment. So we're in pretty good shape because we have others in the seminary as well. I'm not sure how many we'll have after the summer because this young man on my right, we're not related, is going to be ordained in the cathedral next Saturday. And that's another question. Man on my left doesn't belong to me. Yes. But I just want you to know that through the work which has gone on over the years in this diocese, when I first came here, Father John McKay was doing excellent work as Vocations Director, and Father David Kane took over, and we gave it an extra impetus during that time, allowing him to be full time. And since then, we've had Father Matthew and Father John. And it's producing results. We do have a steady stream of vocations. And for that, we can only give thanks to God our Father, because that's where it all comes from in the first place. So we're doing well. Now let me just say something else. To train a priest costs between 150,000 and 200,000. When I was a student years ago doing engineering in Manchester, we were told it cost £100,000 to train a jet pilot. Now it costs much more to train what the army padres call a sky pilot. And it's, but it is £150,000 to £200,000. It's a lot of money. So if you've got a spare house somewhere, you've got some dosh which isn't earning you any interest, and remember you're going to die soon anyway. So, that's a really happy note. I don't mean I last with this, but the fact that we do have so many vocations, it's traditional for the bishop at an ordination to put in a plug for men. So thank you very much indeed to this parish, which has produced vocations in the past. Father Anthony Pateman, who is here. He was ordained in Rome, because in those days you weren't allowed to go back to your parish. And somebody told me Father Anselm at the monastery. Is that true? Is he from this parish? And who else have we got? Is Leo? Are you from St. Peter's? Father Anselm, I should say. Sorry. Leo. Father, who's at Farnborough Abbey. And who else?
Father Kieran.
Father Kieran in Amphiport.
So Father Henson, the white father.
Oh yes, of course. Remember Father Henson, the white father. So St. Peter's has produced quite a few vocations over the years, and I'm glad that tradition is continuing. As far as I know, this is the first ordination in the parish church, whether it's this one or the old. So please, keep praying, and if there are any young men around, you've already got our eyes on one or two, please offer yourself. It really is a fulfilling and happy life as you serve the Lord as a priest. So please, please do that. Now please stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Our help is in the name of the Lord. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is
ended.
Thank you.
Thank you.